In this video, we are going to discuss what is distance and displacement and what is the relation between them. But before starting this video, if you think this video is helpful, then hit the like button. Hello friends, in the previous video, we discussed about motion and rest and what is the relation between them. Now let us move forward. Suppose you are at your home A and want to go to your friend's house B. There are many routes by which you can go to his house. You can choose various paths. First path is the longest, third is moderate, and second is the shortest. You can go by any path to reach your destination. Now, the length of the path covered by you from your house to friend's house is distance. Hence, distance can be defined as the length of the path covered by an object. Distance can be measured in meters, kilometers, feet, inches, etc. Distance is a scalar quantity. Now, what is scalar quantity? Those quantities which can be represented only by its magnitude, that is, number, is called scalar. Example, time, mass, distance, etc. Now, while going to your friend's house, if you took the third path, which is the shortest, then the shortest path covered by you is displacement. Hence, the shortest length of the path covered by an object is called as displacement. Displacement can be measured in meters, centimeters, kilometers, etc. Displacement is a vector quantity. Those quantity which has magnitude, that is number, and direction is called as vector. Example, displacement, velocity, force, etc. Displacement can be calculated by using the formula final position of the object minus initial position of the object. Here, you should know that distance is always positive, whereas displacement can be zero, positive or negative. Suppose a ball is placed at origin O. After some time, it travels 3 meters. Now, at this point, distance is 3 meter as well as displacement is also 3 meter. Here, distance is equal to displacement. Now, after some time, ball moves 7 meter in opposite direction. Hence, distance from its initial position to the final position, which is 3 meters plus 7 meters, which is equal to 10 meters. Here, you can see that its initial position is O and final position is minus 4. Hence, displacement is all about initial and the final position. Therefore, displacement is equal to final position minus initial position. The final position is minus 4, whereas its initial position was the origin, which is 0, which is equals to minus 4 minus 0 is equals to minus 4 meters. Therefore, minus 4 meter is displacement, where negative sign shows that the ball is traveling in the opposite direction. This also shows that displacement can be negative. Let us take one more example. Suppose a man is jogging in a circular path. He is traveling from A to B. So, what is distance and displacement? Distance will be half of the circumference, the path length, which is pi r, whereas displacement will be the shortest path from A to B, which is diameter, which is equals to 2r. Suppose it travels from A and again come back to A. So, the distance will be 2 pi r, which is the circumference of the circle. But we all know that displacement will be 0. Why it will be 0? Since the initial and the final position are same. This shows that displacement can be 0. Hence, we can conclude that displacement can be 0, positive or negative. Distance is always greater than or equal to displacement. If you have any doubt related to the concept in the video, then just comment below. And if you think this video is helpful, then like, share and subscribe friends. Bye.